Ah, yes. Here we are once again. It's Cannabis News, everybody. I'm Joe Clare, your host. It's September 30th, 2019. The show, as always, is presented by the Marijuana Times. It's a new week here at the Marijuana Times. We do Cannabis News 5 days a week. Find us on YouTube, Apple Podcasts, and more. I think I surprised myself. That doesn't happen often. Anyway, I'm leaving it in. I can re-record this now. Real, raw cannabis news. Sometimes I breathe the wrong way when I'm supposed to breathe the other way. It's all part of the charm of the show, or at least that's what I like to tell myself. Today, talking about my trip to your CBD store. Also, new cannabis cafe is opening up in West Hollywood tomorrow. We'll tell you what you can and can't do there, and then more from my trip to your CBD store in Crescent Springs, Kentucky. All that coming up. At first, of course, can't man, I'm in trouble breathing. What was going on? The show. I don't care. It continues to be a train wreck. I don't care. I'm moving forward. The show is brought to you by NatureSide. I'm sure they're loving this. Nature-side.com and organic, all natural pesticides. Grow safe and poison free with NatureSide. Be regulatory compliant. All of that good stuff. And of course, don't use harmful chemicals on things that people are going to be ingesting. That would be awful. That would make you a piece of garbage. That's right. I said it. If you don't want to be a piece of garbage, then you can go to NatureSide. There's other things you can do, but one of the things you can do is go to NatureSide. Nature-side.com, a proud sponsor of Cannabis News. As mentioned, I took a trip. It was Friday last week, to your CBD store in Crescent Springs, Kentucky. Apparently, your CBD store has many, many locations across the country. This one opened up in June in Crescent Springs. A little bit later in the show, I will play you in its entirety my interview with Elizabeth Kirby, who is the owner of your CBD store in Crescent Springs. We talked about a lot of stuff, about the newness of CBD, a lot of the feedback she's been getting, a lot of the education that is going on. You know, as I mentioned in the article, a lot of, especially older folks, they don't, you know, get on the internet and research things. It's not their thing. They go into a store and ask somebody. That's what they're comfortable with. And more as time goes on, we see stores like this. Obviously, as I said, your CBD store has something like, she said, 500 locations. So the knowledge is widespread, and every day there's more and more of these places where people can go to find out about CBD. There's a lot of stuff online. A lot of it is wrong. A lot of it is made up. A lot of it is conjecture. We've talked about this before, about when you buy CBD online, look for third-party testing, things like that. If a CBD company doesn't have, excuse me, I'm having all kinds of problems with my voice and everything. Everything in here is having a problem. I need some CBD. Learning about CBD, there's a lot of information online, but if a website of a product you're getting, it doesn't have third-party testing, if they can't even go that far, that's a product I would avoid. And if you find one of these stores near you, you're comfortable with going in, and that's what you're most comfortable with, going in and talking with someone and learning about CBD. Elizabeth told me they'll sit for 30 or 45 minutes just talking to people about CBD. They got a couch in there. That's where I was sitting when I did the interview. And they'll talk to you. They'll educate you. They'll answer your questions. All that stuff. It's a great thing for a product that is, one, popular, and two, has a lot of conflicting information, and there's not a lot of quote-unquote clinical evidence behind it, because it's really, up until the first weed documentary by Dr. Sanjay Gupta, like 6 years ago, most people, even in the cannabis community, knew very little about CBD and what it can do. Obviously, there's been a lot of studies since then, and that's helping. And obviously, we advocate for more and more and more research. All the research. Do all the research from every angle. If you need humans for clinical trials, I'm sure you'll have no problem getting people to come in and tell you all about CBD. If you give them free samples, they'll talk your arm off about it. All about how it's working, if it's not working, what it's doing, what it's helping, what ingestion method is better. We talk about research like it's this unattainable goal. It's not. If you're a researcher, you're a scientist, and this interests you, then take the steps necessary to do so. I understand. Law, federal law especially, is a hindrance, and until that's changed, it's going to create a lot of problems with various branches of research and various levels, but it is what it is. And so far, the anecdotal evidence is that it helps a lot of people. Some people will tell you that it doesn't help them, but most people will tell you that it does, especially ones that keep at it. They find the right ingestion method. They find the right dose. A lot of trial and error and experimentation, but CBD is safe, so you really don't have to worry all that much about it. And it's not psychoactive. It doesn't really have enough THC in it to have you fail a drug test. Although I have heard that people who take maybe 2,000 or 3,000 milligrams a day of CBD, they saturate, you know, they're all day with the CBD, they're taking it every day. Your THC could build up enough to rise to a level to trigger some more sensitive THC tests. I would definitely beware of that. We'll talk more about your CBD store when I play the interview here coming up. This next story is from LATimes.com. What you can and can't do with the new cannabis cafe in West Hollywood. And if you didn't see the story we did on this before, you're saying, well, what's the big deal? There's going to be, you know, it's a cafe where you smoke weed. But it is something else entirely. The Lowell Cafe is a new restaurant and bar in West Hollywood that will allow diners to smoke marijuana inside and outside thanks to a new license issued by the city. I almost said a new issue licensed by the city. And I just did. Oh, man. It's a rough show. It's one for the books. A new license issued by the city. It's slated to open October 1st. And when it does, it will be the first of its kind. If you're imagining a giant smoky room filled with bowls of weed, couches, and lots of pizza, hey, that sounds good. But think again. That's not what this is. Imagine instead a functional restaurant with servers, plus a special air filtration system that sucks up and filters the smoke from people smoking weed everywhere. When you arrive, you'll be seated at a table and greeted by a flower host, also known as a bud tender, who will serve you your cannabis guide. He or she will drill you on your past cannabis experiences. I mean, they're going to drill you. They'll probably just ask you, right? They're not going to give you the third degree. Whether you're Snoop Dogg level or haven't smoked since high school or at all, and they'll help you personalize your cannabis order. You also have a server from whom you can order food and non-alcoholic beverages. There's a front patio where you can order alcoholic beverages, but you can't use marijuana out there. So they kind of, you know, split it up. But the combining of the cannabis and the food is definitely something that's one of its kind. Chief, are you seeing this? Are you seeing the complete breakdown throughout this episode? It's rare. If you watch a lot of episodes, you know how rare it is. Chef Andrea, not Chief. I almost said Chief Andrea Drummer's food menu. I don't care what happens from now on out, here on out. I'm not re-recording. This is it. This is what you paid for. If you want a refund, go see the concierge and talk to them. Chef Andrea Drummer's food menu. A chef. She's not a chief of anything. She's a chef. She prepares and creates food dishes. Is inspired by the different flavor profiles and strains of cannabis, and each dish will have a suggested product to smoke or vape with. The opening menu will include miso glazed pork belly, jalapeno mac and cheese bites, vegan nachos, sticky tamarind wings, house-made pickles, and avocado and white bean hummus. I don't know what most of that is. What's house-made pickles? This means you made it at your house? It has to be more than that. It can't be that simple. I made these pickles at my house, therefore they're house-made pickles. Some of the things you can do at the new Lowell Cafe. Come in if you're 21 or older and have a valid ID. You can smoke joints and vape both inside the dining room and on the side patio. You can consume edibles. You can smoke or consume edibles you bring from home for a small tokage fee. You can use your own bongs or pipes to smoke or rent one from the restaurant. You can drink beer or wine on the front patio once the restaurant secures its license post-opening. Some of the things you can do is take unfinished products home to consume later, although you can't take food leftovers, but you have marijuana leftover. You cannot take that. You can smoke on the front patio, or you cannot smoke on the front patio. It continues. It's not going to end until I hit the stop button on the recording. So just hang in there. Smoke on the front patio is something you cannot do. License does not allow for smoking on any front-facing outdoor area. You also cannot drink beer or wine inside or on the side patio. Drinking is permitted only on the front patio, so they've separated the smoking and the drinking. They all cannot smoke to the point that you're incapacitated. They'll be keeping an eye on you. You cannot order pizza. Drummer is planning to put some form of flatbread on the menu at some point. The Lowell Cafe will be open daily from 10 a.m. to 10 p.m. Plans to extend its hours to 2 a.m. by Halloween. So if you're in West Hollywood. Well, they're also hoping to introduce a breakfast menu and to start opening at 8 a.m. in mid-November. So that's going to be open 8 a.m. to 2 a.m. That's a lot. If you're in West Hollywood, you can go and check it out. Tell them what a glowing job, what a great job I did on the story. Whoops. Right. Look at that. I almost played the video before I was ready, before I even introduced it. Wow. Wow. It's time to go. I don't know if it's because I'm doing this show early. I usually do it at night, as you can tell behind me. You can see the glow of the sun outside. I don't know what it is, but that's like 10 or 12 major malfunctions during the show. I think more than any other show. It has to be a record. I mean, I don't keep, you know, stats for that kind of thing. Maybe I should. That has to be some kind of record. I even messed up this graphic for what's coming next for the video. I messed that up too. The bottom part is supposed to be the italicized, the bold italic font. There we go. Oh, man. I got to get out of here. It was a bad show. I'm sorry. It was a bad show. Like I said, I could re-record this and pretend none of this happened, but I wouldn't feel good about that. I just wouldn't. This was a bad show. Hopefully I got some information across to you. Hopefully it was entertaining. I find a lot of the major malfunction-filled episodes of my various shows, they tend to be more on the entertaining side, less on the informational side, because you're trying to fight through all the gaffes and things like that, and the graphic snafus and all and everything. I'm done. I don't know what the problem is. I just don't. There's a disconnect somewhere for this episode. This will be the disconnect episode. Anyway, here's my interview. When I was much better last Friday, whatever problems I'm having now, I didn't have then. At least I don't think I did. I might have. Elizabeth Kirby, owner of Your CBD Store in Crescent Springs, Kentucky. Here is the full interview. It looks kind of distorted because it was on my phone. And see, that's another mess up. And so instead of like being the square, it's like spread out. Instead of like the iPhone, you know, like if you have your phone up like up and down like this, it creates the thing with the black on the sides. But this video doesn't have that. It's very, it's spread out. I don't know. Like I said, I got to get out of here. There's no saving this show. There's no salvaging this show. But if you're in Crescent Springs, make sure you check out Your CBD Store. And maybe tell them I sent you. Maybe not. Maybe you're embarrassed. And I would be okay with that. Maybe you're embarrassed to mention my name. That's fine. You know what? Sometimes I am as well. Today is one of those times. Thanks for watching and listening, everybody, and spreading the word and the truth about cannabis. With this show, as I said, check us out on YouTube and Apple Podcasts for the audio version. See, I almost forgot that. Okay. Here's Elizabeth Kirby, owner of Your CBD Store in Crescent Springs. Thanks, everybody. We'll see you next time on Cannabis News.
We're here with the Marijuana Times. I'm here with Elizabeth. And tell us who you are, the name of your store, all that stuff, where people can find you.
My name is Elizabeth Kirby, and I'm the owner of Your CBD Store here in Crescent Springs. We're right off the Buttermilk Pike exit across from McDonald's next to Subway. You can find us right off I-75. You can Google us or look at our Facebook and on Yelp.
And how long have y'all been here? When did you get started?
We opened June 1st of this summer.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
And so far, what's some of the feedback you've been getting from your products?
Great feedback. We have, I would say almost half of our customers are returning customers. So they've tried the product, it's working for them, they love it, and they're back to replenish their supply. Okay. And then of course we have new customers coming in all the time that are learning about CBD. They've heard about CBD, they're not sure what it is, so they come in the door and that's exactly what they say. I've heard about CBD, I've heard it would help me, but what is it? And so we spend a lot of time educating our customers. We'll spend a half an hour, 45 minutes just walking them through, you know, what is CBD? Here is the hemp plant, talk about the endocannabinoid system and how CBD works in your body to help with pain and inflammation, anxiety and different things. And then we walk through all the different products because different products work differently in your body to tackle different things. Yeah. So,
speaking of different products, is there anything in particular that's more popular than anything else, or is it kind of a mixture?
It is a mixture. Here at our store, at Your CBD Store, our most popular product is our topical pain cream. It actually won a national award last month at the National CBD Conference. It came in first place for CBD pain cream in the nation. So we carry a couple of different milligrams in that. The oils are very, very popular. People like to take the oils. The gummies are very popular, and our vapes are very popular. They're a very clean product, no additives or preservatives or anything in our vapes. So everybody returns for those.
Awesome. Mm-hmm. Well, if you're in the Cincinnati area, Northern Kentucky area, hopefully come check it out. Elizabeth, thank you.
You're welcome. Thank you.